Hi, and welcome to this Getting Started video with Hasura, where we're going to do some hands-on time in the console, and you're not going to believe just how fast you're going to have a GraphQL API. Let's get started. All right, here I am at the Hasura signup page. Now, because applications always change, this might start to look a little bit different, but ultimately what you're going to do is we're going to have the signup page visible to us. So we're going to go ahead and I'm going to use an email here. Now I need to verify my email. And after clicking my verify email, it takes me back to the sign-in page. Now, because this is my first project with Hasura, it is going to go ahead and create a new project for me right out of the gate. Looks like it's ready. Let's go ahead and launch the console. So with this process, I'm given a couple of options here to describe my entry point to Hasura. Either I've used it before, I'm actively working with it, I'm completely new, and I'm ready to use it on a regular basis. Let's go ahead and follow the completely new workflow. Here we'll see we have the option to connect to Neon as a database provider to start testing out the interface. If you want to skip it, you certainly can. But for now, let's go ahead and use the onboard flow. I'm going to authorize Neon here off screen. And now we'll see that it's connecting to Hasura. So what's happening here is Neon is provisioning a database for me. It's connecting it to Hasura, and it's installing a sample schema where I'll be able to get started. So here's my sample schema. I have two tables, customer and order, and we can see here a sample query that we'll be able to work with. Let's go ahead and try running that sample query now. We'll see that it's actually pre-populated here inside of my interface. If we go ahead and run that, we'll see that we get the response back from our database here. And yes, you actually have a physically working GraphQL API right now. You're done. Let's go ahead and verify that by creating a new table and exposing that to Hasura. I'm going to go to the data tab here. I have customers and orders. I would suggest let's create a product table. We're going to give it a unique ID. We're going to allow tracking the created at and the updated at timestamps. And I'm going to give it a title to the product. And this should be enough for us for now. That's going to be a string type. And we'll go ahead and add table. We can see now that product exists on our tables. I'm going to go to the API and check to see if I could actually browse that. And I certainly could. Let's go ahead and create a join table that will allow us to have a order product table that will allow us to have products on a specific order. Going to create a new table called order product. We'll give this a unique ID as well, the created at timestamp, and we're going to give this the product ID, which is of type UUID. And I'm going to go ahead and save this because I'm not sure what my order ID is. Let's go to order, modify, and we can see that my orders are actually using integers. I'll return back over to my order product, continue working with this. Order ID is an integer. All right, this should give me enough information to be able to work with my product. Let's add a couple of foreign keys while we're at it. And we're going to do one for our product as well. We'll hit save. This is doing a number of benefits for us, the primary one being that it defines our GraphQL relationships as well. If we come back to this top level of public, we'll see that we have now some untracked relationships between order to order product, product to order product, and vice versa. Let's go ahead and track all of those. And now we have a nice GraphQL relationship between our orders and our products using a standard join table. We'll head over to the order to grab a simple ID. We'll use order number one. And we're going to go ahead and make a new product here that's going to allow us to be able to attach something. It appeared to be something with juice, so we're going to add some fruits, apple and orange. Let's go ahead and browse those rows because we're going to need to access those IDs. Copy both of these to my clipboard. Go to order product now. Insert a row where we had order ID was 1. Product ID is going to be the orange there. And then we'll add apple as well. If we browse our rows, we should see 2 unique entries of our product IDs that allow us to see our data. Let's go ahead and test that out in the API. And there we have it. We can see that we have our orange and our apple as attached products to this order. And that's it for our GraphQL API. Let's go ahead and test one more feature here where we'll want to see what the external world would have access to from our GraphQL endpoint. If I turn off the authentication token here, we'll see that there's no more access to any of my fields. Let's fix that by creating an anonymous role. To do that, I go back to my project settings here. I'm going to go ahead and hit new environment variable, and I'm going to search for unauthorized role, where I'll give it the value of anonymous. I'll hit add. And once I've added, I'm going to go ahead and go back to my project and head over to my data tab here. From my data tab, I'm going to simply expose the product titles to the external world. Go to permissions, add the role, and we'll give select permissions without any checks on just the title. And we're going to limit the number of rows to the first 10. All right, back over to the API Explorer. We'll see now that we do have access to the product. We can go ahead and drill down on that, and we'll see that we have access to title. Alrighty, with that, I can have a protected API that is able to expose partial data to the external world, and I'm able to iterate and resolve on my API. All right, I hope you had enough here to get started with your own projects. If you have any questions, find us on Discord, on GitHub, or anywhere else you'll find a Hasura member. Have a nice day.